Welcome to ECG class number 3. Today I am going to discuss on myocardial infarction. When half thickness infarction occurs, that is subendocardial injury, the intracellular potassium comes out. So when potassium exits, repolarization occurs. When potassium exit repolarization stages such as ST segment and T wave will be changed. Hot change will be occurred. Hot change will be formed. ST elevations may be elevated or may be depressed. When subendocardial injury occurs, current flow or impulse flow from the normal tissue to the cavity, that is away from the chest lid V5 or 6. This chest lid shows the ST segment depressions. But when full thickness injury occurs, that is transmural myocardial infarction occurs, current flow from the infected area to the chest lid, that is outwards. This chest lid shows the ST elevations. These elevations, convexity is upwards. Convexity faces upwards. This is acute myocardial infarction. This is also acute myocardial infarction that indicates subendocardial injury. This is also acute myocardial infarction that indicates full thickness injury or transmural myocardial infarctions. Now I am going to discuss the different shape of the ST segments, elevations or depressions. These figures shows, first figure shows ST depressions, but upward sloping ST depression that is found in normal condition. And second figure shows plain ST segment depressions that indicates myocardial ischemia. Third figure shows downward sloping ST segment depressions that indicates also myocardial ischemia. Fourth figure shows ST segment depressions with T inversions. And these ST segment in these ST segment depression, convexity faces upwards. This T inversion is called strain pattern T, which is found in the ventricular hypertrophy. These are the ST segment depressions. Last two figures shows ST segment elevation. When ST segment elevation and convexity faces upwards, this indicates acute myocardial infarctions. But when concavity faces upwards, it indicates pericarditis. I am going to say acute MI evaluations in ECG. Before attack, ECG shows normal. After acute attack, just minutes afterwards, ST elevation occurs. Hours afterward, ST elevations remains, but T inversions occurs. Days afterwards, ST comes to the isoelectric line, as T inversions remains. And weeks afterwards, pathological Q develops and ST segment remains in isoelectric line and T remains in normal positions. How a pathological wave is formed? This figure shows the pathological wave, Q wave, pathological Q wave formation. Here, when the acute MI occurs in full thickness, that is transmural acute MI. This portion is infarcted area. It is electrically neutral. So, in this phase, the chest lead V5 or 6 faces the septal activations. These septal activations, that is this impulse, passes away from this chest lid normally this impulse produces Q wave, but when a window is formed, this impulse produces a deep Q wave, that is pathological Q wave.